Hi, beautiful people. Today we are going to be learning how to transfer an image using transfer paper. You can use this to transfer an image onto paper, which I'll be using today, but you can also substitute the paper for a canvas or even fabric if you wanted to like transfer an image onto the back of a denim jacket, etc. What you will need is a piece of tracing paper, a piece of transfer paper. This comes in a roll. A regular surface, so like computer paper or canvas or a wall or whatever it is that you're going to put your image on. And you can either use a light box. I don't have a light box, so I'm actually going to be using my computer screen as if it were a light box, and I'm going to try my best to show you how. Also, you probably need a piece of tape. This is just plain masking tape. Okay, cool. So first things first, you want to find your image. So you have your image, you know what you want to do. Usually when I am doing a portrait or teaching someone how to do a portrait for the first time, we will simplify the colors in the face using Photoshop. So you scan the image in, or you save it, download it, open it up in Photoshop, go to adjustments, go to posterize. And that's how you can break your image down into smaller or fewer colors. For my case, I actually don't have a person. I'm doing the image of, what do you call this? A crown made out of thorns. That's what I'm using because I'm actually going to be... Oh, I should do it onto the hoodie. It's okay. I'll do that next time, or I'll do that on my own time. But basically, I'm going to be painting an image onto a sweater, and I'm going to be using a similar process. So I'm just going to show you how to do it with that. So I would take my tracing paper. If you don't have a light box, if you don't have a... Well, there's a couple of things. So once you create your image, you can print it out. Say you have access to a printer, you can print that image out, and then you could just literally lay it flat on the table and trace it. If you don't have the best lighting, or the surface that you're working on is not a good color for tracing, you can take the image that you printed out and the tracing paper, tape them both up to the nearest window and use like natural light as your light box. Or if you don't have a printer, because again, this is during quarantine season, I don't know if you have access to a printer or if you feel like going outside, waiting online 6 feet apart at Staples to go and get something printed for an art project. If you have a computer or an iPad, even a cell phone, if you don't mind working really small, you can use the actual light from the screen as your light box and pull your image up. So I will show you. So I would just take my tracing paper, I would put like 2 to 4 pieces of masking tape on it. And then I would tape it up to the screen. After I tape it up, I'm gonna move the camera so you can see, because unfortunately I don't have 2 cameras, maybe in the future. So I'm literally just taping a piece of tracing paper to my screen. Masking tape is super friendly. It won't damage your screen or your computer in any way, shape, or form. And once that's done, I'm going to now show you what it looks like. I thought that would work. It didn't work. Why did that not work? So this is what the image looks like that I pulled up, and I have placed a piece of tracing paper over it and taped it on all 4 sides. So now what I'm going to do next is I'm literally just going to trace it, or whatever is important to me. So remember, when you're tracing, you have the authority to edit out what you don't want in there, and then later on you can add in things that weren't there. For me, I'm just gonna do a quick outline of the crown, and I'm gonna literally draw with a pen on top of the tracing paper on top of my computer screen. Okay, so now I'm gonna actually go ahead and do the tracing situation. I'm not gonna do like a super fancy job because this is just a demo, but you get an idea of how you can get that going, right?
So, don't mind me. I wish I had some like jumping music. Hold on, let me play some music while I'm working. Okay. I probably should have picked that more simple image, but it's okay.
Okay, you get the point. So I'm just taking the tape off, keeping the tape because you can use it again. And you can see that I have traced my crown of thorns, right? Now, next step. In order to transfer the image onto transfer paper, next step, so I've traced my crown of thorns. And now in order to get the image onto the paper for my drawing, I put the paper down first, right? I would also suggest you tape it down. The more tape, the better. You don't have to OD, but basically you don't want the image to be slipping and sliding around and then you gotta go ahead and do it over. Or you've done all this intricate tracing and then here you go without your desired image. It's really annoying. Second, transfer paper. The most important thing about transfer paper is to remember that when you are about to transfer an image, the dark side should be facing down. So the dark side of the transfer paper should be facing down, and that allows the graphite, which is on the paper, to end up on your surface. Okay, so I'm gonna put this down. Now I'm probably gonna also add two pieces of tape. And again, if you're working on canvas, you would put it on top of the canvas. If you're working on a wall, you put it on the wall. Wherever you're working, that's where you put it. That's completely up to you. And, yeah, I don't like it when things slip and slide because it just gets really messy. Graphite is naturally already a very messy thing to work with. And now this is the thing that I just did off my computer, right? And I'm going to tape it right on top. Now, when you're using transfer paper, you don't have to use a pencil. Most people recommend it, but it doesn't matter. As long as you use a surface with a point, and as long as you press nice and hard. Don't press so hard that you rip your paper, but almost that hard. Because you're basically pushing the graphite down to onto your surface to look like what you're drawing on top, if that makes sense. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And I don't know if you can see.
Maybe. All right, so I'm just literally going over very sloppily, mind you, because we want to do this quickly. But I'm just going over the marks that I already made. One thing that also might be helpful is when you first trace it, like say you trace it in pencil from the screen or from your light box, then when you go back again, you may want to trace it with another color. So sometimes, like, for example, my students will do pencil for the first trace, and then we'll pick a color pencil, like a blue or a pink or a red, for the second trace so that you know what you trace. Because what you also don't want to do is to accidentally leave out a whole section of your, a whole section of your image, because then that's really annoying. Because again, once you move it, it's almost impossible to get it to go right back where it, oh my, that's a lie. It's not impossible. It's definitely possible to get it back where you had it, but I just think it makes more sense to do it right the first time. So, like I said, you might want to use two different images, one for the first trace, one for the second trace. And I'm almost done here. Not quite, but almost done. Okay, almost there. Almost there.
Okay, cool. All right, so I have successfully traced over the drawing that I did from my computer screen. So you see it's a little bit darker now because I did the second one. I use the same color ink, but I always recommend that you use two different ones, especially if you're new to doing that. And then now I am gently taking up my transfer paper. I say gently because if you smudge it, you'll end up with smudges on your paper or on your surface, and then you have to go ahead and get rid of it, right? And you can see that, maybe you can see, can you see? You can kind of see what was traced. You see the same design? And then, yep, I have graphite on my computer table, which is not cute. It's okay though. And then, and now I have my image. And so now I would just add paint. And if I was working with Photoshop and different layers, I would have traced each and every layer. And then I would, if you want, you can actually go and label it and put black, red, blue, and then kind of fill it in and paint by numbers. So that is how you transfer an image using transfer paper. Okay.